Good morning, children. Welcome to your iLearn English Language Live class. Today we are going to study a new chapter, that is conjunctions, and this chapter is the part of your test 4 syllabus, which will be held in October. Right. So before starting or before getting into the detail of conjunctions of this chapter, first of all, let us have a look at all these sentences. Okay, looking at these examples will help us to understand the scope or the subject matter of this chapter. So let us look at the first sentence. I like to watch movies, but my sister likes to read books. Okay. Then the second sentence, they couldn't go out as it was raining. Work hard or you will fail. They came, it should be came, not can. Okay. They came and helped me. So in all these four sentences, what do you observe? That there are two things being said in each sentence, fine? And both the two things or two ideas have been joined using a particular word, fine? Like in the first sentence, you see, but. In the second sentence, as is there. In the third sentence, or is there. In the fourth sentence, and is there, okay? So if you see, if you look at the first sentence, I like to watch movies, okay? This is one thing, fine? This is one idea or one statement. Then my sister likes to read books. So if we look at them individually, both of these sentences, they give us two different ideas, fine. But if we want to join both the sentence, then this concept of conjunctions come into place, okay, come into existence. So here, but as soon as we use this conjunction, but over here between these two sentences. So now we come to know that this word is playing the contrast. Okay. It is bringing out the contrast between my choice and my sister's choice. Fine. So it is joining two ideas, two sentences. Again, they couldn't go out. Okay. This is one sentence. If we look at it individually, then it was raining. Again, this is another one complete sentence. But how do we relate these two? How, if we join it? So if we add as over here, so it gives us the reason, okay, why they couldn't go out. Why couldn't they go out? Because it was raining, as it was raining. So just with the addition of, or with the use of this word, this conjunction, we come to know the reason. Fine. The second sentence, the second part of the sentence becomes the reason of the first part. All right. Then work hard or you will fail. Here you can see that a condition is being given. Right. So there are two choices. Either you work hard or you accept to fail. Okay. Then they came and helped me. So this again is showing the combination of two ideas. They came, some people came. And what did they do? They helped me. Fine. So this is the role which is played by a conjunction. I hope you people must be able to, able to guess what is the role of the word conjunction. It is used to join. Okay. And it plays different roles in different sentences. Fine. So we'll come to the next slide and see what is there. So here we come to the definition of conjunction. What is a conjunction? Basically, it is a word, okay, which is used to join two words, fine, two phrases or two sentences. So it is not necessarily that a conjunction will be joining only two words. It might join two phrases also. You are well aware of phrases now. And it is also used to join two sentences as we saw in the previous slide. Okay, so these are also, conjunctions are also known as the joining words. All right, they are used to join two ideas. Now, conjunctions, they are of three types, fine? There are three kinds of conjunctions depending upon their function, okay? One is coordinating conjunctions, then subordinating conjunctions, then correlative conjunctions. So, we are going to deal with each of them in great detail, one by one. Now, what are coordinating conjunctions? They are used to join two independent clauses. Okay. Now, if you remember, what are independent clauses? Does anyone remember what is an independent clause? I've told you. We've done this. Yes, ma'am, please unmute anyone of them.
Divyanshi. Divyanshi.
Independent clauses are the clauses which can stand alone and make perfect sense.
Fine, but what is a clause? First of all, tell me what is a clause.
Clause is a group of words
yes.
which has a subject and a verb in it.
What kind of verb? That is also important. Finite verb. All right, very good that you remember this much. So a clause is something, it's a group of word which has a subject and a finite verb in it. All right. And the clauses are again of two types, independent clauses and dependent clauses. Independent clauses are those, as the name suggests, that they can stand on their own. All right. When they are written, then they express the complete meaning. Okay, they are not incomplete. So they are known as principal clauses also, independent clauses also. Fine. So I hope you remember what are finite verbs. So I'm not going to get into the detail of that. Okay. So in coordinating conjunctions, they join two independent clauses. Okay, this is important to make a note of. Then there are seven coordinating conjunctions. So coordinating conjunctions are only seven. Fine. And then there are correlative conjunctions, and then whatever conjunctions are left, they are categorized as subordinating conjunctions. Okay, so there are only the coordinating conjunctions are only seven in number. Fine. So let us look at them. Okay, so there is one very easy way to remember the all seven coordinating conjunctions. Fine. It is FANBOYS. The acronym is FANBOYS. So F for A for stands for and, N stands for nor, B stands for but, O stands for or, Y stands for yet, and S stands for so. Fine. So here we do not have because and the other conjunctions which you use. Fine. If in the question it is specified that you have to join two sentences or join the sentences which are given using coordinating conjunctions, then you will be using only these seven. Fine. So if it is mentioned clearly specified that you have to use coordinating conjunctions, so you will be using only these seven conjunctions. Okay. For here plays the role of because. Fine. So for is plays the role of because over here, and rest of you, rest all other you people are aware. Okay. Now we come over to the subordinating conjunctions. Now, what are subordinating conjunctions? Where are they used? They are used to join an independent clause with a dependent clause. Okay. So, in the previous one, that was a coordinating conjunction, what did we study? That they are used to join two independent clauses. Okay. Both the clauses which were joined were both of them were independent in nature. But here when we come over to the subordinating conjunctions, then what do we observe? That they are used to join an independent clause with a dependent clause. Okay. So let us have a look at the different types of subordinating conjunctions. See, there are a lot of conjunctions. Many conjunctions, okay, the words which are categorized as the subordinating conjunctions. I told you in the beginning only that apart from those seven FANBOYS conjunctions and the coordinating conjunctions and the correlative conjunctions, whatever words are left now, they all are categorized under subordinating conjunctions. And those conjunctions, those subordinating conjunctions are also divided, or they are further categorized depending upon their functions. Okay. So what all functions are played, roles are played by the subordinating conjunctions? It is some subordinating conjunctions, they express time, some express place, then reason, fine, result, purpose, concession or contrast, then comparison and condition. So these all are the functions, okay, or the roles which are being played by the subordinating conjunctions. And depending upon the roles, on these roles, we have different conjunctions. Okay. So let us dwell into this one by one. Okay. So what are the words, what are the conjoining words which express time? Fine. So it is very easy to understand this. When, whenever, before, while, so anything which is giving you the sense of time. Fine. After, since, until, as long as, right? The first time, the last time, the next time. So all such phrases are also considered as the conjunction. Okay. Then let us have a look at the example, and then you will understand it in a better way. Deepti has been happy ever since her parents came to live with her. So this is one idea. Deepti has been happy. Okay, since when? So since her parents have come to live with her. So this word since, it is giving us a sense of time. Okay, it is giving us the relation between Deepti happiness and her parents' arrival. Okay, her parents living with her. So this both these ideas are joined by this conjunction, specific conjunction, which is a subordinating conjunction. Because if you see this part, her parents came to live with her. Okay, this is a dependent clause. It is not an independent clause because it cannot stand on its own. Her parents came to live with her does not stand on its own. Okay, Deepti has been happy ever. This also does not stand on its own. Okay, so if you see that two dependent clauses are being joined, or one independent and one dependent clauses are being joined, then the conjunction which is used there is the subordinating conjunction. Okay, so since is a subordinating conjunction. Next example, if you look at it, is the first time I ate that dish, I was surprised by how sweet it was. Okay. So the first time here, it is acting as your conjunction, right? Then, when he came to look for me, I was sleeping. So again, when. It is not necessary that your conjunction will be, you'll find a word, joining word in the middle of the sentence, fine? They can come in the beginning as well, okay? So there is no hard and fast rule for that, that the conjunctions, they have to come in the middle. That is not necessary. They can also come in the beginning of the sentence, but they will not, you'll not find any conjunction towards the end of the sentence. Fine? Either in the beginning or in the middle somewhere. Moving on to the next joining words. They are where and wherever. Now, as you see the conjunctions which are used under this category, they denote place, fine? They are expressing place. They are giving a sense of place. So wherever we looked, there was confusion. So all the places or all the points we looked at, there was confusion. This is the place where I lost my purse. So the relation between place and me losing my purse, fine? So you can see that both the ideas are being joined, okay, using a subordinating conjunction, which is where. Then reason, what are the conjunctions which are used for reason? Because, since, and as. So you can see over here, then since is also used for denoting time. And since is also used for denoting reason. So depending upon the sense of the sentence, we'll have to choose the conjunction and use it over there. All right. Shubh, please pay attention. You're just turning the pages of your book. That won't work. Pay attention on the screen. I've written everything over here. You need not go through your book. Then, Renu didn't sit for the last test since she was out of town. All right. So, here since is not telling us the time. It is giving us the reason why Renu couldn't appear for the test, because she was out of town. So, instead of using because, we've used since. So, because and since, and as, all these three words can be used interchangeably. All right. Because all these three words, they give us the sense of reason. Fine. Then Varun wore several layers of clothing as it was really cold outside. So as again, it is giving us the reason that why Varun wore several layers of cloth, because it was really cold outside. So you can see that we can also use because and since over here. So if you use any one of these in order to give a reason, you'll be correct. All right. But suppose if this sentence, this particular sentence had to be joined, fine, using a coordinating conjunction. So what would we use instead of since over here? Who can tell me? Ma'am, please unmute anyone.
Ma'am, for.
Very good. So for will come. Okay, that is what I wanted to know. Next is comparison. Comparison, you know, when the things are being compared, all right? So what are the words? As, than, whereas, as much as, rather than. So again, you see, as also plays the role of comparison, and it is also used to give reason, fine? So again, we'll have to look at the sense of the sentence, okay? Then we'll have to use accordingly, like he is as naughty as his brother. So in simile, you people have studied simile also, fine? So what do we use? We use as in simile because we compare something to the other thing. Then Sam is taller than Joey, so than is also used for comparison. That means we are comparing the height of these two people, so than is used, fine? And than is used when there is a difference in the level, okay? And as is used when two things or two persons are of same quality or of same level. That is, if you see in the first sentence, he is as naughty as his brother. So both he and his brother are what? Both of them are equally naughty, fine? But here, if you see, Sam is taller than Joey, so there is a difference in their level. Okay, somebody has height is taller than the other one. So they are not of the same level. All right. So when there is a difference in level, then we use than. And when we have to equate two things, then we use as. Moving on to the next function, that is purpose. So purpose is what are the conjunctions which we use to denote purpose? So that, in order that, and lest. Okay. So Abhinav is working hard so that. Okay. What is his purpose of working hard? So that he may get admission in the best college. All right. So here you see, first of all, the action is being given. All right. And then the result of that action is given. So in such sentences, you will understand on your own that you have to use a purpose, okay? A conjunction which denotes a purpose. So Abhinav is working hard. This is the action, all right? And what is the result of this action? He may get admission in the best college, fine? So why is he working hard? What is his purpose of working hard? That is why we are using a conjunction which is denoting a purpose. All right. So here you have to understand the difference between reason and purpose. Okay. Then I ran lest I miss the bus. So can anyone tell me what is this? What is the meaning of lest?
Ma'am, is it then also?
Then also, no. Yes, Anvi.
Ma'am, you gave me the permission.
Okay, Arav.
Ma'am, or?
No. Not or, actually. I'll tell you. See, lest ma'am, means...
Ma'am, although.
No. Lest means if I don't do this action, then, you know, this would happen. Fine. So, if not, then. This is the meaning of lest. Okay, if I won't run, then I'll miss the bus. That is the meaning of lest. All right. So that means if I do not fulfill the condition, then, you know, something will happen with me and something negative will happen. So there, lest is used. Understood? Okay. Now result. See, in case of purpose, we were using so that adjacent, writing so that adjacent to each other. Fine. But when we use so that in result, then we use so and then we use that after writing some, after giving some, you know, extra information. Like he was so tired that he could not walk. All right. So here result is being given. Fine. So he was so tired, as a result, he could not walk. So you can see that so and that are split. Okay. They are not used next to each other. Then the boys made such a great noise that nothing could be heard. So again, here that is giving us the result. Right. And the result of what? The result of this action. Okay. So see, you can find purpose and action confusing. Okay. Purpose is used where, you know, the action is, the result is probable. Okay. Or expected. Fine. Like this in the first sentence, Abhinav is working hard so that he may get admission in the best college. So here he is expecting this result. This result has not happened. All right. This thing has not happened yet. But in case of result, where you use conjunctions which denote result, in such sentences, you will see that the results have already been obtained. Fine. He was so tired that he could not walk. This thing has already taken place. Okay. The boys made such a great noise that nothing could be heard. So result is also there and reason is also there. So there we use the conjunctions which denote result. All right. Okay, next comes concession or contrast. Now, what are the words which are used to denote this? Though, although, even if, okay, whatever, while. So these are the words which are used to denote concession or contrast. If we look at the first example, we'll understand it. Although I left my home early, I was late for my classes. Fine. So here, although is bringing in the contrast that what should have been the result, what should have been the expected result for this. If you leave early for some place, then you should arrive at that. You should arrive at your destination on time, isn't it? But in contrast, in opposite to my action, in opposite to the expected result, something else happened. Fine. So the something opposite happened. So although I left my home early, I was late for my classes. Okay. Whatever I eat, I feel sick. I feel sick. So if you eat something, then you should feel energized. Fine. You shouldn't feel sick. But here in contrast to my action, if you get a contrasting result, there we use such words. There we use such joining words, which express the contrast between your action and the expect and the result which you get. Okay, next comes condition. Condition, the words, the joining words which are used to express conditions are if, then, and provided that. Okay, so if you are hungry, then have some biscuit. So what is the condition of eating a biscuit? That you should be hungry. Fine, so if you are hungry, then have some biscuits. And if you take the car, I'll take the bike. So this again is a condition of me taking the bike. Fine. If the other person will take the car, I'll take the bike. So here condition is it is very simple. If then and provided that, only three things are there under condition. I hope you people have understood subordinating conjunctions. Okay. So now we move on to the correlative conjunctions. All right. So these conjunctions are pair of words that help to join two balanced clauses, phrases, or words. So you will find these correlative conjunctions always in pair. Okay. So they are used to help. They are used to join two balanced clauses, fine, which are both of the clauses are of equal nature, and or phrases or words, okay, which is the function of conjunction. So let us have a look what are correlative conjunctions. So some of the correlative conjunctions you can see all of them are in pair, okay. Both is always used with and, either is always used with or, okay, neither with nor. Nor is individually also used, but it is used where? In the coordinating conjunction, okay, van boys. Then not only, but also, if whenever you'll use no sooner, you'll have to use than, okay. Whenever you'll use whether, you'll have to use or. Whenever you'll use hardly, you'll have to use when, okay. So this is the pair which goes together. In most of the pair, you will see the second word, they are also used individually. But, you know, if you are using no sooner, then if you will not use than, then your answer will be incorrect. So you have to see which pair goes together. Fine. So we'll have a look at the examples. Okay, our first example is, not only is he foolish, but also obstinate. So not only and but also, you can see the balanced clauses are balanced. Okay. Here we are telling the two characteristic of a person, foolish and obstinate. So we are writing not only and but also. No sooner did the bell ring than the children ran out of their classes. Right. So again, you can see that as soon as the bell rang, the children ran out of their classes. So here, no sooner, this is how you use no sooner and than. Then hardly had I reached the station when the train came. Okay, so this again is the usage. You can see the usage of hardly and when in this sentence. Fine. Now, so if you have understood till here, let me know, or if you have any doubt, you can ask. Yes, Yashi.
Ma'am, please show me the last slide.
Yes, here it
is. Ma'am, this is the first example. Not only is he foolish, but also obstinate. Ma'am, as the verb is used before the subject, it is a question.
No, it won't be a question. This is the structure of writing correlative conjunction in, I mean, these correlative conjunctions. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
It will be a question when is would have come in the beginning, extreme beginning. Okay. Is he foolish? That would be a question. Ma'am, please unmute Divyanshi.
Ma'am, as coordinating conjunctions, they are always joined to independent clauses. And ma'am, in independent clauses, there should be a subject. But on page number 81 in book, in an example, it's written that he picked up his racket and went out to practice.
Let me go to page number 81 first. Yes.
And the second one.
He went out, he picked up his racket and went out to practice. Yes, here in this case, see, that is also, see, you people must have, and I assume that you people know how to join conjunction. Because when, you know, the pronoun is same, like he picked up his racket, he went out to practice. Okay, suppose you are, suppose I split these two, this sentence into two different sentences. What would it be like? He picked up his racket, full stop. He went out for practice. So when we join two sentences and both the sentences start with the same pronoun, then we drop the next pronoun, the second pronoun, right? Yes. Isn't it? Yes. Yes. So I assume that you people already know this because this is something which is very basic. Okay. Anything else? So if you people have understood, shall we proceed to the practice session? Okay. Arav, you have doubt or you want to answer the question? That is why you are lazy without even seeing the question. You doubt.
Unmute.
Ma'am, can you give an example with the condition provided that?
Okay. Wait. See, the first sentence you see, if you are hungry, then have some biscuit. Fine. If you want to use provided that, how will you write? You can have some biscuits provided that you are hungry. Right? The condition comes afterwards. Okay. So this is a set of 5 sentences on your screen. Okay. I am giving you a minute's time. All of you are required to go through these 5 sentences and combine these sentences using a coordinating conjunction. So you have to keep this thing in mind that you have to use nothing but a coordinating conjunction in order to join these sentences. Yes, I want all of you to attempt these sentences. Don't just sit like that. And if you have done, you can raise your hands. All right. So first one can be answered by Athar. Ma'am, please give Athar the permission to answer.
Ma'am, I like coffee, but my sister prefers tea.
But my sister prefers tea. Yes, fine. Next one, he takes milk in his tea. He takes sugar in his tea. Yes, ma'am, please unmute Unnati.
He takes milk and sugar in his tea.
Correct. So Divyanshi, do you get this point which you asked? Yes. So here we have omitted he. We've used he once, and in his tea has also been repeated. So we'll use in his tea also once. All right. Next. Switzerland is not in the European Union. It is not a member of NATO. Ma'am, please unmute Hiral.
Switzerland is not in the European Union, nor is it a member of NATO.
Very good. Yes, correct. So we'll be using nor over here. Next, she must have been very hungry. She ate everything immediately. Ma'am, please unmute Sudhanshu.
Ma'am, she must have been very hungry. No, she ate everything immediately.
So?
No.
No?
Yes, ma'am.
So will not be used over here. Ma'am, please unmute Shubh.
Ma'am,
She must have been very hungry, for she ate everything immediately.
Yes, correct. So for will be used over here because it is giving the reason. Okay, how do we come to know that she was hungry? Because she ate everything immediately. Fine. Ritu has never taken music classes. She sings melodiously. Let me see who will answer this one. Okay, ma'am, please unmute Sanvi.
Ritu has never taken music classes, yet she sings melodiously.
Yes, good. Yet she sings melodiously. Correct. All right. Moving on to the next exercise. You can see a set of 7 sentences on your screen. Now you have to complete these sentences with subordinating conjunctions. Okay. Fill in the blanks using subordinating conjunctions. Take some time, write down your answers, and then raise your hand. Yes, quickly complete this exercise. Only 7 sentences are there. Okay. Let us discuss the answers now. Ma'am, please unmute Insha. Yes, Insha. His grandpa said the climate was different.
His grandpa said the climate was different when he was young.
Very good. When he was young. And here, when is denoting what? Muted. So here you can see when is denoting time. All right. Next one, ma'am, please unmute Khushi. He has been feeling sick dash he came back from holidays.
He has been feeling sick after he came back from holiday.
What else can be used? After is also correct. Yes. No, after will not be the appropriate one. Has been is being used over here. You've done tenses. Can you think of anything? Okay, we'll move to Arav. Ma'am, please unmute Arav.
Ma'am, we can use since here.
Yes, since will be used over here. All right? Correct. Next, let us wait in the bookshop dash the rain stops. Ma'am, please unmute Akshita.
Ma'am, let us wait in the bookshop until the rain stops.
Yes, until the rain stops. Okay. Next one will be answered by Samrid. Ma'am, please unmute Samrid. You cannot be a lawyer dash you have a law degree.
Until.
Yes. Next, she has not called dash she left last week. Who Manu can answer this one?
Since she left last week.
She has not called. since she left last week. Okay. Next, he was angry dash he heard what happened. Who has not answered so far? Priyanshi. Please unmute Priyanshi.
Ma'am, he was angry when he heard what happened.
Here it should be what. Okay, when he heard what happened. Correct. Next, he had to retire dash of ill health. He was not answered. Ma'am, please unmute Vartul.
Ma'am, he had to retire as of ill health.
As of ill health. Okay. What else? Can you use because also over here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So not at every place you will be using as, okay, interchangeably with because. So here because is more appropriate. Fine. Okay. So here we come to the next set of exercises. Correlative conjunctions. Complete the sentences with correlative conjunctions. 6 sentences. Ma'am, please unmute Divyanshi. Divyanshi, you have to answer the first one. She is dash intelligent dash beautiful.
Ma'am, it will be. She is not only intelligent but also beautiful.
Okay, what else can be used? Not only but also.
Ma'am,
is correct.
Can I rejoin? I cannot hear you.
All right. So what else can we use in this sentence? Ma'am, please unmute Athar.
Ma'am, she is neither intelligent nor beautiful.
All right, in a negative manner. What else can we use? Priyanshi?
Ma'am, she is both intelligent and beautiful.
Yes, so both intelligent and beautiful, not only intelligent but also beautiful, neither intelligent nor beautiful, all these three answers are correct. Okay, but if you'll be using either or, then it will be little inappropriate. Fine. Next, I will dash go for a hike dash stay home and watch TV. Okay, let me see if you can answer this one. Javeria.
You can unmute Javeria.
For a hike or home and watch TV.
Repeat your answer, child.
I will either go for a hike or stay home and watch TV.
Yes, I'll either go for a hike or stay home. So either or is appropriate over here. Next, Jerry is dash rich dash famous. Ma'am, please unmute Arpit.
Ma'am, Jerry is both rich and famous.
Both rich and famous. So here also we can use Jerry is not only rich but also famous. Jerry is neither rich nor famous. All three are correct. Okay. Next, he is dash intelligent dash funny. Ma'am, please unmute Soumya Oja.
Ma'am, he is not only intelligent but also very funny.
Yes, he is not only intelligent but also very funny. Correct. Next, have you made a decision about dash to go to the movies dash not? Okay. Ma'am, please unmute Sanvi.
Have you made a decision about whether to go to the movies or not?
Very good. Whether to go to the movies or not. And the last one, dash had I put my umbrella away, dash started raining. Bhumanyu has not answered. So ma'am, please unmute Bhumanyu.
No sooner had I put my umbrella away than it started raining.
No sooner and then. Okay, what else can we use?
Neither had I put my umbrella away nor it started.
No, raining. Hardly and when. Okay, hardly had I put my umbrella away when it started raining. Fine? All right. So, yes, so we come to the end of the chapter now. Thank you. I hope you people have understood this chapter because you could answer all the questions fairly well. Fine? So,